Hello everyone, and thank you very much for inviting me to this meeting. I will talk to you about the importance of promoting the growth of companies with purposes. In my career, I have focused all my effort to promote and apply the concept of a human company. A human company is an organization that puts people at the center, values and cares for them as the most important asset. It's a company that shares purposes and objectives, promotes a collaborative environment, develops and allows talent to be expressed, takes advantage of diversity, and operates to achieve a positive economic and social impact. A human company is capable of adding strengths, abilities, and motivation of each one of the people that compose it, achieving better and more lasting results. To achieve this objective, the role of a business leader is very, very relevant. We have to remember that the strength of a company is in the quality and diversity of its people. Diversity means accounting for differences in gender, age, culture, experience, language, nationality, and disability. Let me now offer some consideration about it. I want to start with the importance of experience. Age is not a limit. It depends on the energy, motivation, and objective of each one. Experience is always valuable even when technology transforms the knowledge. Age is experience. Means to have lived the personal and the professional adventures, having had management responsibility, coordinated people, designing the processes or project, and obtained result. These experiences will continue to have value even as business tools and the design change. What we call soft skills are those that are based on experience and human relationship. Continuing now with the importance of diversity, I want to focus on the gender diversity because it's a clear opportunity. The strength of a woman is to be a woman, to process information in a different way, to have different sensibilities, and to have multitasking abilities. We are needed women leaders, and to achieve this result, it's important that women believe in themselves and in their abilities. Just as more young people are needed to bet on STEM faculties to reduce the current gender gap in the scientific and technological sector. Regarding now the board of directors, we reached 30% of women, and now, according to the last decision of the European Union, the recommendation is to arrive at 40%. Although the law has been a necessary measure to expedite the process, today in the board of administration we not only have a greater participation of women, we have a talent women, professional and prepared, very committed on the position and their responsibilities as director. I think that with their presence, they are helping to improve corporate governance. Unfortunately, the same is not true at the management level. There are still a few women general manager or division manager. In this area, an adequate level of gender diversity has not yet been achieved. It's a big problem because there are many studies, such as the InnoDiversity Index by AI Foundation, relate diversity to innovation, and innovation is one of the most important keys today. Another issue is the gender wage differences in labor parity, also that remain to be resolved. Resolving that is very urgent and necessary to improve personal motivation. It's necessary to create cultural and practical conditions so that women who want to have or already have children can continue in their careers demonstrating their talents. It's interest of companies to achieve a real parity of opportunity that generate healthy competition among all human resources and to achieve the best possible business results. This responsibility is even greater for male leaders who must give space to talent and in particular female talent. Many studies have shown that greater diversity, particularly that of gender diversity, brings improvement in performance and economic growth. Today, more and more investors are betting on companies whose attention to diversity and social impact is greater. We have to be positive because the sensibility on this issue is increasing. But we need also to accelerate this process. Another challenge for the current generation of leaders is harnessing new technology and innovation to transform and make our economic system more sustainable. The challenge is based on redesign of strategy and industrial processes. A transition of the value chain to a circular economy model that value raw material and modify the current form of production, packaging, distribution, and consumption. Making consumer products biodegradable or recyclable is a way to extend the life of raw materials and is a necessary revolution to improve the planet and its sustainability. Transforming our economy system while respecting biodiversity, which is humanity's greatest capital, means making our life system sustainable over time. European culture is the most fertile ground for the sustainability of this issue and can be a guide and a world reference. Thank you very much for your attention.